Alright, so today we're going to be using the TIS Techstream Toyota software to scan this RAV4 for engine code and some traction control codes. First, we're just going to go to connect a vehicle. There's our vehicle, 2005 Toyota RAV4. We're gonna go to next. All right. Here are our control units. We got engine and ECT, cruise control, ABS, vehicle stability control, traction, immobilizer, and SRS. So right now we're interested in engine and vehicle stability control. Just going to double click on that. Alright, this vehicle actually came from a body shop, and they claim that there was just a vehicle stability light on, and that there was no check engine light, and they were testing some stuff, and a fuse blew. So, probably what I'm going to start off by doing here is just clearing all these codes and seeing what comes back. Clear. Okay. All right, now we're going to go back to select system. We're going to go into our ABS, vehicle stability control, and track. See what we have for codes in here. Okay, so we got no codes there, so that could have possibly been triggered by the check engine light. So now I'm just going to shut this vehicle off and restart it and see if we get anything that comes back. Alright, we got nothing. Except our maintenance light. Now, the people at the body shop thought their scan tool may have been malfunctioning too because they couldn't get into the engine control module. So, I'm just going to drive this vehicle around a little bit and see if the codes come back. If not, we may end up just giving this back to them. But let me show you around this tool a little bit more while we're here. Let's go back to select systems. And let's say we want to program an ECU. ECU programming. It's going to pull up. It's going to ask us which ECU we're interested in. Let's go to engine control module. And we're just going to go down here to the low. Checking their server for updates. All right, and this is what we get here. It says calibration number, and then it says calibration update. No. So, there are no updates for the CCM. If there was, basically this is going to tell us there is, and then we're going to go ahead and be able to proceed with it. So, programming with a TIS software is pretty easy. Let's just go ahead and we'll go ahead and check the ABS module over here. If there's any updates available for that. And just gonna come down here and hit the arrow key. Checking. And looks as though it's not pulling a Cal ID, so maybe this one's not programmable. I'm not 100% sure what that one means, but if anybody does, I would be glad to know. Or if there's anybody out there that might know a little bit more about this than I do, I'd love to hear your comments below. Because I haven't done a whole lot of Toyota programming, so that's kind of why I like playing around inside here, just to see what the functionalities are. So. Well, I'm going to close this out. Our check engine light and track light hasn't come on back on yet, so that's good. Let's just go back in here and see if we got any pending trouble codes. Got our activation test over here, data list, monitors, utilities. I'm just gonna, we're in trouble codes right now, still saying no trouble codes. Let's see what we got for activation test. Injector volume, air fuel control, fuel pump, AC clutch, purge valve, canister purge, tank pressure bypass, rail valve timing control, shift lockup solenoid, line pressure control, FC IDL prohibit, TE1 TC. So we got all sorts of stuff here. It's pretty nice to be able to have these kind of functions with the factory software. We have a number of different factory scan tools here. Alright, well that's going to be it on this little tutorial of the Techstream Toyota factory scan tool software. If there's anything in particular you want to see, I'd be more than glad to make a video on it. Just leave it in the comments below. If this was helpful in any way or you enjoyed watching, thumbs up. And as always, thanks for watching from the Flat Rate Mechanic. Till next time.